God made covenants with humanity. He chose this special dude, a guy named Abraham, right? And he made a covenant with Abraham, the Abrahamic covenant, Genesis 12. And in that covenant, he promised Abraham that he would bless his seed. Of course, Jewish people are being from the seed of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. That's Jewish people today. And if you think about it, we see that covenant being fulfilled today. Because if you look at any of the people's group from the time of Abraham, from the time of the Old Testament, really, most people group, actually pretty much all of them, are no longer here. They're not with us. They don't really have any, clear descendants. But God said that he would keep and that he would bless the seed of Abraham. And today, we still have descendants of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
We can look at God's faithfulness to his first promise in Genesis 12. Abraham was not such a great guy, and yet he's seen as great today by the major religions, the monotheistic religions of Islam and Judaism and Christianity, not because of him, but because of God who makes and keeps all of his promises.
There was a covenant that he made at Sinai in which he granted to the nation the opportunity to learn how to live with him. I see that whole period dating from the Sinai into the living in the land of Israel up through 586 with the destruction of the temple as God's very, very clear revelation of what it means to live in community with him in an imperfect world, but with his presence in the midst, Emmanuel, God with us, the Shekinah glory with the nation through all that time, the down payment on the coming of the Holy Spirit, his glory indwelling people, the transformative power of his presence amidst the nation.
Later on, he made another covenant, other promises to a king named David. And what did he promise David? Well, he said to David, hey, from your line, I am going to bring a ruler that's greater than Moses, that's greater than you. I'm going to bring the Messiah. And of course, we know that Messiah Yeshua, Jesus, came from the line of David. Very important. So although at Scripture we see God making different covenants,
the covenant to David, the promise of a seed that would come through him, that seed happened. You know, we see Jesus, the descendant of King David, with prominent Gentiles in that line. You think of Ruth. It's just a remarkable story. You look at the genealogies in Matthew and Luke. So those covenants were very, very important. To tell the gospel story as it unfolded throughout the Hebrew Scriptures and ultimately dovetail together the coming of Jesus.
God made promises to Israel. Some of the promises have been fulfilled, like he promised to Abraham that he was going to make of his descendants a great nation, which he did. He said they're going to be, sometime they were going to be dispersed, Deuteronomy 28-30. People have been dispersed after they have sinned. They are removed from the land. But the Lord says, but I will bring you back to the land. So we see that being fulfilled. So we see that prophecies are being fulfilled. It's no coincidence that after 2,000 years of having been expelled, that small nation is today in the Middle East again. The Hebrew language that was lost for 3,000 years, was lost by the time of Jesus, is now the common language in the state of Israel.
Out of the ashes of the Holocaust, the Jewish people as a nation are reconstituted back in the land that was given to Abraham and Isaac and Jacob. And to just ignore that as a simple, fact of history that has nothing to do with Bible, that has nothing to do with the Great Commission, that has nothing to do with the hope, the blessed hope, I think that's a little bit short-sighted.
There was the new covenant mentioned in Jeremiah. Never heard about that growing up in Judaism, but the promise of this renewed covenant relationship with Israel and yet extending out to the nations because of the blessing that God had promised previously to bless all the nations. The characteristic of that new covenant being the forgiveness of sin, the indwelling of the Spirit, and knowing God. All that's right there in the Hebrew Scriptures in Jeremiah 31.
And all of us who are followers of Messiah Yeshua, of Jesus Christ, all of those of us who are His disciples, we enjoy this new covenant, Jews and Gentiles alike. And what's the seal of that covenant? What is that covenant? Well, it's of course faith in the perfect sacrifice of Messiah Yeshua, of Jesus Christ, where He went to the cross and died for our sins and rose on the third day. And today, because of that, we have, and those of us that are His, we have a great privilege to be called sons and daughters of the King, to be royalty, to be adopted into the family of God.
And so the greatest blessing of the Abrahamic covenant is that Jesus came. And so that's a continuation, I think, of the Abrahamic covenant is the new covenant. And in you all the families of the earth will be blessed. So we can't ignore how it all began in order to see its ultimate, Matthew 28 fulfillment.
The promises that God made to Israel include the blessing of the Gentiles. And we see that the Gentiles have been blessed by the coming of the Messiah. And the Messiah has been shared with the Gentiles. And they are being grafted in, and now we are all one. Yet we have to understand, God is just fulfilling what He said He would do. Sometimes we fail to see God's way and God's plan.
Yeah, I mean, all the covenants are actually made with the people of Israel, also the new covenant. So in a sense, so the new covenant did not actually start, you might say, with the church. It starts at Pentecost, actually. In a sense, it was effective at Pentecost, but it was a group of Jewish people who came to know the Messiah, Jesus. Some proselytes were there from the nations, but mostly they were Jews. God made all the covenants with Israel, in a sense, and He had a plan to reach out through Israel to the nations.
Evangelism to the Jewish people really shows the faithfulness of God, to His promises, to His covenant, going back to the time of Abraham. And I think that if under the New Testament, the Jewish people who in general have rejected the Messiah, and if that would be the end of the story, I think there would be something lacking in terms of the faithfulness of God, the goodness of God to everything in the Old Testament. And so I think that the Jewish evangelism is important, not just because Jewish people, just like any other people, desperately need to hear the gospel of Christ, but also because the coming back of the Jewish people to the Messiah shows something, a great thing about the goodness of God, about His faithfulness, and that He has not forsaken His people of old.
And that's the importance of covenants. The importance of covenants is basically the importance of God reaching out to us, human beings. And it all started with, for us Jewish people, of course, it all started with a guy named Abraham. But all of it is fulfilled and all of it is consummated in Jesus.